Swami Narayana Narayana Narayana
Swami Narayana Narayana Narayana
Swami Narayana Narayana Narayana
Yanvasan Swami and Yanvidi Swami in this today's morning talk. I thank my managing committee members and my library committee members who are always eager to give me chance to organize Swamiji's lectures here in our Jujimthana Club. Today, Swamiji is going to talk on right to think big. I am sure everybody will enjoy this subject. Now I will request Swamiji to come on the stage. Now I will do the bouquet. I will request our president to give the bouquet to the Swamiji. Dusra bhi de. I will request Sri Mohan Bhai. Rajni Bhai, before he sits down, to give the floral tribute to Swamiji. I will request Kishan Bhai Choksey. How, sir? I'll request Mr. Umesh Gandhi. Dondonde. Sir. Shri Bhupen Cheda. Mr. Pankaj Vora, Mr. Deven Choksey, Mr. Narayan Pasari. Our treasurer, Mr. Pukhanwala. Mr. Ashok Mehra. Now, I will request Nitin Mangaldas Bhai. How, sir? Welcome.
Good morning to everybody. It's my honor and pleasure to introduce today's speaker, Pujya Gnanansal Swami from BAPS Swaminarayan Sanstha. As you all know, the BAPS Swaminarayan Sanstha is engaged in the spiritual and social upliftment of the mankind. BAPS has activities spread over 62 countries world over and is engaged in 160 activities, educations, hospitals, as well as the supporting the public or a common man at the time of natural calamities. BAPS has also constructed or rather built 1,300 mandis all over the world, spreading the Hinduism as well as the virtues of the mankind, which one should always try to strive for. The BAPS always has engaged itself in upliftment of the common man, and that was the goal of our Guru, Param Pujya Pramukh Swami Maharaj, that in the good of others lies our own, and that was the motto with which the BAPS is working even today. Actually, today is the most auspicious day for us, because our sixth successor after Param Pujya Pramukh Swami Maharaj, Pujya Mahan Swami Maharaj, is also in Mumbai at the Dadar Mandir, and also we have Pujya Gnanansal Swami for this today's speech, which is the subject of our right to think big, whether it's a good choice. Pujya Gnanansal Swami has qualified as a BE Mechanical, and he has taken a diksha and he is initiated in a sadhu by Param Pujya Pramukh Swami Maharaj in 1992 at the time of inauguration of Akshardham Gandhinagar. Thereafter, he has worked with Pujya Pramukh Swami Maharaj as his personal interpreter over a number of years, and he has traveled across the globe and participated in conferences world over, and his words of wisdom has been sought after by everyone, whether it's a small town or to a larger audience like I am Bangalore or I am Ahmedabad or Calcutta. We are fortunate enough that Swamiji has agreed to give us his words of wisdom at least once in a quarter, and we are also lucky that Juhu Gymkhana and especially Sri Shailesh Bhai Gandhi and his managing committee is always providing us entire infrastructure for this today's lecture. Shailesh Bhai Shah for providing this entire infrastructure for delivering this words of wisdom to us. Now let's tighten our belts, let's ready for a takeoff, and let's have our Swamiji on the floors to have our subjects of the today. Let's think big, let's strive for the big ideas, let's achieve a vertical in life, let's be more achieve inner wealth of the life. Now Swamiji, I request you to take the floors.
गुणातीतोक्षरं ब्रह्म भगवान पुरुषोत्तमः जनो जानन्निदं सत्यं मुच्यते भवबन्धना। श्री स्वामीनारायण भगवान की जय। अक्षर पुरुषोत्तम महाराज की जय। राधा कृष्ण देव की जय। सियावर रामचंद्र भगवान की जय। प्रमुख स्वामी महाराज की जय। महंत स्वामी महाराज की जय। प्रमुख स्वामी महाराज शताब्दी महोत्सव की जय। With prostrations at the divine feet of Bhagwan Swaminarayan and my Guru Hari, Param Pujya Pramukh Swami Maharaj and Param Pujya Mahan Swami Maharaj, my heartiest namaskar, good Sunday morning, and Jai Swaminarayan to all the guests. Nice to meet you after like just 3 to 4 months. And the topic for the talk today, the right to think big, make a good choice. Once upon a time, three monkeys were sitting on a coconut tree and they were discussing things as they were said to be. Said one monkey to the other that there's a rumor that can't be true that man descended from our noble race.
Three monkeys were discussing things, and one monkey said, there's a rumor in the town that man has descended from our noble race. And the second monkey jumped, how did you get this? And he said, I was sitting on the parapet of a science college, and the professor was teaching the students that man has descended from the monkeys. And the third monkey jumped to that branch and said, the very idea is a disgust. And the first monkey said, why? And the third monkey said, the very idea is a disgust because here's the thing a monkey won't do. He said, what? He said, we have never seen a monkey to use a knife or a pistol to take another monkey's life. We have never seen a mother monk to leave aside her babies with others to bunk. He listed out many things. And from that all the three decided, yes, men, the ordinary caste, might have descended from somewhere, but not from our noble race. This is because the thinking of the 21st century man, when it comes to norms, beliefs, routines, disciplines, and ethics, has gone down to that level that even the monkeys, they don't want to call themselves as the ancestors of our human generation. The biggest loss of the 21st century man is the loss of our right to think big. Because we have incurred this loss, we have ceased to become a human being to quite an extent. In the most developed nation of the world, in the most cultured nation of the world, in the most advanced nation of the world, I'm talking of USA. You know the statistical figures, if I put forward you, you will be amazed, surprised, and shocked. In America, there is a murder every 17 minutes. There is a rape every 9 minutes. There is a theft every 7 minutes. There is a burglary every 3 minutes. 40% of the British populace are compulsive gamblers. A child under 10 is daily killed by his mother in Japan. There are 4 million abortions in India every year. Man has ceased to be a human being. So they wear the t-shirts, being human. Actually, I tell them, you have worn it, now wear it inside to the sleeve. These are a couple of things that I put forward you. But you see the scenario of the society in the 21st century. It's decaying. Mankind is in urgent need of something moral. Something more spiritual. But for that, we have to exercise our right to think big. We are designed to think big. We have the potential to think big. We are not utilizing that energy to think big. We are pleasure-loving people. Rather, we have become pleasure-loving people. We have become leisure-loving people. And so, mean thoughts, mean actions, mean practices, and of course, with all this, you get mean results. The biggest discovery of the 21st century, when it comes to human thinking and human behavior, is that we rediscover our right to think big. We need to rediscover it. The most urgent need of the 21st century man. We have gone down to the animal level, to the animal instincts. Half of the newspapers you see every day are filled up with humans with animal instincts. In this word, I incorporate many meanings, you understand? I repeat, half of the newspapers every day are filled up with news of humans behaving with animal instincts. Right or wrong? We have lost our right to think big. And that is why we have lost this place, because we wanted to make it heaven. So the first important aspect is to rediscover our right to think big. And it is always not the privilege of the academically qualified people. It is not always the privilege of the rich. Every human mind is potentially divine. Every human mind is potentially capable of thinking big. It does not have to be always a Harvard graduate for that. Yes or no? I'll tell you a very good story. A tycoon, a billionaire, he asked a car company to make a customized car for him. And the car was made. And when the car was supposed to be rolled out from the manufacturing unit to the roads, they found out that the car was about 2 inches taller than the exit gate. Now there was an issue, how to bring the car out. And so they decided to scrap it out. The painter said, I'll redo it, no issues. If the top of the car, the scratches, the color, I'll redo it. They did not find the idea good. So they approached the structural engineer. They said, doesn't matter. I'll break the beam and you can get the car out. They were discussing, and while they were discussing, the security at the gate, he was looking at things. And he said, sir, if you don't mind, can I suggest something? You, in this issue, this is our mentality. The start of thinking big comes here. चपरासी मुझे कोई अच्छा विचार दे सकता है लेकिन अभी एक रिसर्च तैयार हुई है यूनाइटेड नेशन से ऑफ द 100 बेस्ट इन्वेंशंस एंड डिस्कवरीज अपॉन दिस अर्थ दैट इंक्लूड्स द व्हील एज वेल वेर गिवन बाय पीपल ऑफ क्लास 3 एंड क्लास 4 सॉरी 70% ऑफ द टॉप 100 बेस्ट डिस्कवरीज एंड इन्वेंशंस द क्रिकेट स्टेडियम्स आर फुल टुडे बिकॉज ऑफ द आईपीएल द T20 द आइडिया came from the brain of a class 3 employee who was as a clerk sitting at the ICC office in London. From the basic question, why do football stadiums go full and why not cricket stadiums? The basic question. And from that evolved the idea of T20. And now you see cricket has revolutionized. Now they're thinking of T10. I don't know what will happen to it. My meaning to say is that it's not always the privilege of the big and the rich or the qualified and academically well off. It can come from any brain because each and every human brain is potentially divine to prop up with the best ideas for the betterment of mankind. So this gentleman, the pun, rather the gatekeeper, he approached it, I have a suggestion. He said, kya? What? And he said, if you deflate the tires, if you remove the air from the tires, the car will be 2 inches down, you can just roll out, fill air again in the tires, and then you can take it off. Oh my God, beautiful idea. The painter, the structural engineer, the manufacturer, the owner of the company, oh well puzzled, and the class 4 karmachari, he gave a wonderful idea. The tires were deflated, so it automatically, the car was 2 inches down. It was rolled out of the manufacturing place, again out, the airs were filled, and the fine, the car was driven home. Newton had the biggest puzzle of his life, you know what? Sir Isaac Newton, who has given more than 150 inventions and discoveries to us, the calculus that we study in standard 12, the laws of motion, the laws of gravity. You know, he writes in his autobiography the biggest puzzle of his life. It was, he had 2 cats, one was a bigger cat and one was a smaller cat. And he had made a hole for the bigger one. He always had a problem that how can the second one go through this hole? So he actually had to create 2 holes across the wall for the 2 cats. Many years after creating this hole, he came to know the hole from which the bigger cat can move, the smaller one can.
So it's not always the privilege of the rich, privilege of the mentally or thoughtfully rich. That's what I'm talking. So the first important aspect that we need to understand in this topic is that each and every human mind is potentially capable of thinking big. It is not always the privilege of Harvard or Oxford graduates. First important aspect is this. And this is what actually differentiates us from the rest of the animals. According to the genetic sciences, latest research, there is 99% similarity between a chimpanzee and a human being. 99% similarity. The only 1% difference between a chimpanzee and a human being is we have the power to think. We have the power to think. We have the distinction of analysis. We have the power to put inside concentrated effort. We have the power for skillful execution. We have the power to collect information. We have the power to transform that information into knowledge. And we definitely have the power to transform that knowledge into wisdom. This is the 1% difference between chimpanzee and you. That is me, both. That 1% we are not utilizing to the optimum. John Ruskin, the English poet, used to say, the history of mankind is the history of thoughts. Because everything that we see around us was once in a thought process. It came out as a thought from a human mind. And then we see this creation. The history of mankind is the history of thoughts. It's a fundamental thing. So now you have to keep your eyes open, your ears open, your consciousness in alert position. Then you learn lot many things from around you. You gain lot many aspects of thinking from people, things and circumstances around you. If we were sitting in front of the apple tree and the apple had fallen down, what would we have thought? Kya Bhagwan ki kripa yaar? Aur apple leke khate khate ghar chale jate. Newton ne dekha, kuch fark pada. हमने देखा होता तो कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ता क्योंकि the right to think big we have not exercised it. People have. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam writes in his autobiography. He says that in 1944, when the World War II was at its peak, I was a small child. And coming from a very humble background and a very poor family, to make the ends meet, after his school time, rather before his school time, he had to go from home to home delivering newspapers. He did not have a bicycle. He did not have footwear. So he used to run around the village to drop newspapers at every house. While delivering newspapers, he used to read those newspapers. Because he was not privileged to get a copy of it at his own home. In which he read the news that the German fighters, they were called the Spitfire in the Second World War. He was distributing two newspapers, Swadeshi Mitra and Dinmani. He read on the front page that the Spitfire fighter jets, they used to drop bombs over London. And he got interested in aviation technology. And at that moment, while delivering the newspapers, Kalam writes that I decided to make my career in aviation technology. The right to think big. Every person possesses this right. And he exercised this right. He did it. And India got the missile man. India got the father of its end program. Such stories you would find in abundance
when you read the biographies and autobiographies of great and successful people, I would say more than 50% of them had very humble and rather poor beginnings. But if you decide to think big, if you not, with all the resources you will fail. If you decide, with lesser resources you can still succeed. Choice is yours. Make a better choice. And the biggest thing that God has created upon this earth is that if you have the right kind of attitudes with thinking, there are many resources that it has the power to attract it. If you have thinking, there will be resources to put that thought into practical purposes. And if you don't have the right thinking, the best of the resources available to you at your command would not help you to grow. This is an absolute fact of life. Once a small boy at the age of 12, he was sitting in a London park in front of the Big Bang Tower, and 12 noon time, and the bang started. The first bang, and he got a spark. The little boy's name was Wellington. His mother, she was working as a sweeper in the garden. So she would take her child with him and she would sweep the garden. And at that time, the child would be sitting on the bench reading something, playing. The first bang and sparked something, and he said, Wellington will become the mayor of London. Second bang, Wellington will become the mayor of London. For 12 bangs, he counted, Wellington will become the mayor of London. And at the age of 22, still it holds a record that he became the youngest mayor of London. You think big, you decide to go for it, you can achieve. In personal lives, in family lives, in your social circles, in your professional careers. If you decide, you can. So excellence is not an accident. It is not a lucky draw. And remember, it doesn't come by destiny. Excellence is a combination of very high intention, adequate determined effort, and an excellent skillful execution. For this three, you need high thinking. Otherwise, excellence won't come to you. Moderation, it is natural to anybody. Average performance comes naturally. Excellent performance doesn't come naturally. The seed of excellent performance lies in your thinking big. I just talked from the career point of view, but in all the aspects of life. But as I said earlier, I put forward one small half statement that this 21st century generation, we all are used to pleasure loving life. Financially settled, we say, if we are financially settled, what do we say? Shanti jai yaar. Bidhu finance ma shanti nahi aati. Financially settled, shanti jai yaar. 5, 7, 10 family, extended families, you are comfortable with? Maja aave se yaar. So our mindset has come down to a level of pleasure-loving lifestyle, leisure-loving lifestyle. So, it is not conditioned to think big. Mean minds, they discuss people. Average minds, they discuss events. And great minds, they discuss ideas. 90% of our talking and discussion and gossiping includes people. Dekh lena. Function mein hum gaye the, usko ye pehna chahiye, ye nahi pehna tha. मुझे मिलने वाले थे नजर घुमा ली बाजू में बैठे थे सामने नहीं देखा आफ्टर द फंक्शन टू आवर डिस्कशन एट होम इज दिस टेल मी फेथफुली कीपिंग हैंड ऑन योर चेस्ट यस और नो इज नॉट स्ट्रॉन्ग यस दिस हैपन्स डिड यू गो टू द इवेंट फॉर दैट द रिवर्स ऑफ दिस इज ट्रू इफ यू डिस्कस पीपल You are a mean and a cheap mind. If you discuss the outcomes, the positive outcomes of the event that you attended, it's an average mind. But that is good, satisfactory, acceptable. And if you discuss some good ideas or some good happenings in a way that could help be helpful to you, your family, people, society, nation, whatever, it is a good mind. It is a developed mind. It is an evolved mind. And it is called big thinking. But the pleasure-loving and the leisure-loving lifestyle basically comes from this kind of thinking which has to be let off. In the Indian scriptures, Domna Rishi ki ek baat hai, his disciple asked him, how can I come out of the vices that I have entered? And Domna Rishi said to his disciple that you start thinking in the reverse process of the process which got evolved in your mind because of the thinking that got into you, the vices. कोई व्यसन में से कोई बुरी आदत में से अगर आपको बाहर निकलना है तो हाई थिंकिंग बिग थिंकिंग चाहिए ना तो कैसे शुरू प्रैक्टिकल कर सकते हो स्टार्ट थिंकिंग एंड एक्चुअली स्पीकिंग सेंटेंसेस इन योर माइंड अगेंस्ट दैट फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू आर अ चेन स्मोकर और अ सिगरेट स्मोकर एंड इफ यू वांट टू लीव यू मस्ट बट इफ यू वांट टू लीव देन 10 20 25 30 40 टाइम्स इन अ डे यू हैव टू टेल योरसेल्फ that this is not good for my health. I must leave it. At least speak. That will start trigger the thought process, which can be helpful. So Domna Rishi, he gives us an idea how to go for the big thinking. Decide upon the vices that you want to leave and you have to give your thought processes against it. And that can be very It is a bit difficult, a bit hard, but then it is the only process that happens. When Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam wrote the book Transcendence, My Spiritual Experiences with Pramukh Swami Maharaj, it's a wonderful book. He wrote 30 books in his lifetime, perhaps for which he got more than 48 honorary doctorate degrees in his life. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam wrote the last book of his life, this Transcendence, subtitled My Spiritual Experiences with Pramukh Swami Maharaj, in which he writes and he explained it to the youngsters when he came to dedicate that book to Pramukh Swami Maharaj in 2015 in Sarangpur, the last years of Pramukh Swami when he was resting there. In the youth assembly, he gave a wonderful formula. He said, big thinking gives you righteousness in character. Big thinking gives you righteousness in character. Righteousness in character gives you the beauty of personality. Beauty of personality gives you harmony at home. Harmony at home gives you order in the nation. And order in the nation gives you peace in the world. Beautiful formula. I repeat, big thinking gives you righteousness of character. Righteousness of character gives you the beauty of personality. Beauty of personality gives you harmony in the home. Harmony in the home gives you order in the nation. And order in the nations together brings peace in the world. All starts with big thinking. All comes down to that. And that is why we could see why did Kalam generate this formula. It came from his thinking that he requested everybody that when I die, even on that day, forget on my anniversaries, but even on that day, don't declare a holiday. I want people to work even on my day, on the day when I'm dead. They should not leave the services of the nation. Otherwise, he knew that on that day, it would be declared, and it was declared, it has to be as part of the process and as a salutation to such a great man. But then his thinking was this. So people have come up with big thinking. Society comes up according to Kalam's formula with this big thinking. The best and the highest thinking what I can do in a particular circumstance or a situation or a happening has to be thought first. The first response is always the animal instinct. suppress it a bit and give a second chance to thinking, and from animal instinct you rise to better human thinking and behaviors. Got it or not? Give a second chance to think. So it is always together, think and rethink, never alone the think. Because the think alone is definitely absolutely filled with animal instincts. Usne mujhe mara, ab main bhi dekh lunga. Usne mujhe ye kaha, main bhi kahunga. The first thinking is always an animal instinct. The rethink after the thinking gives a human touch to it. And that is the base of big thinking. And only those people have rose above certain ranks. Only those people have climbed the heights or achieved certain levels of human behaviors and giving to society. Those who have decided to think big, decided to exercise their right to think big. Why did I put the word right? Is we are potentially capable of thinking it, but we are not exercising the right of it. That is the biggest problem. The biggest problem that we are facing. Now coming to practical situations. What will inspire you for bigger thinking? First important aspect is your consciousness. Sometimes we are physically present and mentally absent. This will not help you. Physically present, mentally absent, then it is not going to help you. Consciousness, one, alertness. What is happening around me? Who is sitting? Who is talking? What I am supposed to talk? That alertness, how am I supposed to behave? Consciousness and alertness of people and happenings around you will give you an inspiration for higher thinking. Very fundamental thing I am talking. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam writes in this book, Transcendence, that when I was very young, his father was a mullah. Just meters away from his house was a church. A few meters away from that was a mandir. So in the evening, in his compound, the priest from the church, the pujari of the mandir, and the mullah, his father, all three would get together and they would alternatively recite from their religious texts, and then they would discuss on it that what is the common thing that has been taught to us by the great seers of the past. Kalam said, I subconsciously used to hear all this while playing around in the compound. But then those words entered. At least he writes subconsciously, but then much things went into it because it was in a conscious state of mind. And he said that one of our saints, Thiruvalluvar, he said once that if you want to experience divinity, where would you, and what is the practical proof of experiencing it? And he said that in the presence of somebody, if your any emotional pain disappears, take that presence as a cosmic reality. Take that presence as a divinity. For many years, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam had stored these words in his mind. So this is consciousness and alertness of big thinking. And in the year 2000, when he met Pramukh Swami Maharaj in Delhi, he had many inner frustrations towards happenings in society. Being a very noble and a gentle personality, he would not outburst those things. But he had that deep concern, why not my country, a fully developed country? So for that, he used to constantly ponder upon that. But in the presence of Pramukh Swami Maharaj, he started experiencing that my emotional pain is getting dissolved. At the end of 1 hour meeting with Pramukh Swami Maharaj one-to-one, he felt totally relieved because he got in the presence of Pramukh Swami Maharaj not only that experience, but the right kind of understanding through words in the form of knowledge that how could all the problems of the world can be dissolved. He was very much impressed. At that time he repeated these words. His vision was making India a superpower by 2020. He writes in this book. He wanted to make India where it would be peace without wars. He wanted to make India where there would be love without hatred. He wanted to make India where there would be prosperity without poverty. But he would constantly get disturbed because of the happenings in the society. As I said, half of the newspapers every day is filled up with humans in animal instincts. Pramukh Swami Maharaj at that time gave him a wonderful advice. To be at peace with himself. And Pramukh Swami Maharaj said, see, we are the creatures of God. We have our destinies. At the same time, by our hard work and right ethical thinking, we can have a change in our destiny as well. Our job is to do the right things at the right time for the right kind of people. Leave the rest in God's hands. He decides. The other meaning of karmanya vadhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana. This big thinking introduced in Kalam's mind by Pramukh Swami Maharaj made him feel relieved. He writes this in his book. That Pramukh Swami, he made me feel relieved because of this giving. And Dr. Kalam writes that my formula for world peace got generated from this meeting with Pramukh Swami. See, consciousness and alertness of the people and circumstances around you. He asked Pramukh Swami for a boon and said, Swamiji, I love younger generation. Because you know when Kalam passed away, Times of India in the obituary, it wrote that Kalam was not a biological father to anybody, but then he was the father of the younger generation. The Times of India wrote for him. He asked Pramukh Swami for a boon that I want to breathe last in front of my students. Bless me for that. Pramukh Swami had put his hand on his head and blessed him. And we know that while he was talking to management students at Shillong, he breathed his last. So, the first important aspect to go towards big thinking is consciousness and alertness during your meeting with people, conversation with people, or the happenings around you. Kalam picked up that because of his consciousness and alertness that this is cosmic divinity. God teaches us many things through our normal and easygoing conversations and associations with people. But because we are not conscious, we are not able to pick up. Bhagwan ki daya bahut hoti hai. Ordinary conversations mein kisi ke saath, ordinary association mein, kahi achhi baatein humko sikha dete hai. Lekin wo leisure pleasure loving life hai na. Isliye pick up nahi hota hai. वो पिकअप नहीं होता है भगवान की तो इच्छा होती है बिकॉज वी आर गॉड्स चिल्ड्रन सो वी डोंट पिकअप एंड सो डॉक्टर एपीजे अब्दुल कलाम राइट्स दैट डॉक्टर ब्रह्म प्रकाश वॉज माई टीचर ही टॉट मी एन प्रोग्राम डॉक्टर विक्रम साराभाई वॉज माई टीचर ही टॉट मी मिसाइल टेक्नोलॉजी बट माई अल्टीमेट टीचर इज प्रमुख स्वामी महाराज बिकॉज ही टॉट मी हाउ टू पुट असाइड आई एंड माइंड एंड मी एंड देन वर्क एंड एसोसिएट विद पीपल Biggest thinking. Biggest and the highest thinking starts with this when your eye becomes small. और eye बड़ा रख के आपको आज तक कितना लाभ मिला वो आप लिख लेना With a bigger eye, you break relationships. With a bigger eye, sometimes you don't progress in businesses. Yes or no? Relationships or business, दोनों में प्रश्न आते हैं प्रमुख स्वामी महाराज को किसी ने पत्र लिखा था एंड रिक्वेस्ट की थी कि आप आशीर्वाद अंग्रेजी में लिखना इतना ही वाक्य लिखना आई ब्लेस यू प्रमुख स्वामी वॉज एबल टू राइट जस्ट द लेटर्स ऑफ इट सो ही टुक द हेल्प ऑफ अ सेंट हु कुड हेल्प हिम फॉर दिस एंड सो ही रोट आई ब्लेस यू आई स्पेस बी एल ई एस एस स्पेस वाई ओ यू And then the saint, when he saw this, everything was written in capitals except the I. And the saint said, Swami, it's a common norm, according to English grammar, that the first letter of the start of the sentence, after the full stop, is always capital. Pramukh Swami said, I know it. But keep the eye always small to enjoy life. Keep the eye always small. Or eye agar aap bada rakhte ho, that is the principal barrier of you not going to your fullest potential of big thinking. Principal barrier. Kyunki eye bada rakhte ho to koi aapko information dega. Haan, pata hai mujhe. I know it. Nahin pata hai bhai saab. Bolte na mujhe nahin pata hai. Please. Kyunki agar aapne kaha ki achha, to aapko aisa lagta, aapko aisa mehsoos hota hai कि ये सोचेगा कि उसके पास इंफॉर्मेशन है मेरे पास नहीं है तो मैं कैसा लगूंगा. एम आई एनालाइजिंग थिंग्स प्रॉपरली? आप मुझे हाँ कहते रहना जैसे मैं बोलता जाऊं. सो दिस इज द बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लम इन द सोसाइटी एंड वी आर नॉट एबल टू एक्सरसाइज राइट टू थिंक बिग. वी आर नॉट मेकिंग अ गुड चॉइस बाय कीपिंग द आई बिग. And nobody's big eye has stood. Nobody's big eye has stood the test of time. Right or wrong? Yes or no?
Yes.
And those who have reduced their eye to ashes, they have stood the test of time. How many of you know the name of your great-grandfather? Raise your hands. Quite many of you. Impressed. How many of you know the name of your forefather of the 15th century? अगर अभी आपने उंगली ऊंची की तो मैं आपको खड़ा करूंगा. Nobody knows. How many of you know the name of Narsi Mehta or Mirabai? They were from the 15th century. Now my question to all of you. You are not related biologically to Narsi Mehta. Yes or no?
Yes.
He was not your forefather. He did not leave a property for you in his will. Actually did not happen. The story is continuing. He did not leave a property for you in his will. Right or wrong? My simple story. Straight away question on your chest is, you know his name when you were not related to him and you don't know the name of your forefather of the same times whose blood runs in you. Give me the result. You know the name of Narsi Mehta 500 years back and you don't know the name of the person whose blood runs in your veins who was of the same times. Give me the name of a couple of kings of the 15th century, a couple of emperors of the 15th century. You don't know. I knew the name of Narsi Mehta or Mirabai. Not many reasons, not big reasons. The only reason is that I don't say that your forefathers, they didn't do anything upon this earth. But at least they didn't do one minimum thing. They did not reduce their eye to ashes during their lifetime. And these people, they dissolve themselves for an entity, reduce their eye to ashes. And so they have stood the test of time. As simple as that. Eye reduced and the big thinking starts. I tell you, you read the best of experiments, surveys, or researches, all three. Experiments, surveys, and researches in social relationships and better living upon this earth. More than 1,000 books from the West. And against that book, I would keep simple verses of Narsi Mehta, Mirabai and the great saints of the Swaminarayan Sampradaya like Muktanand and Premanand Swami, and you would find that those from the researches today from the West for better social relationships or better human life were already told 200 years, 500 years back by this great saint poets of India.
तो वो थिंकिंग उनके पास रिसर्च सर्वे और एक्सपेरिमेंट के बिना आई कहां से? आया ना? गॉट माई पॉइंट प्रॉपरली? 500 साल पहले उनको सोशल सर्वे उनके पास नहीं था, एक्सपेरिमेंट करने के लिए कोई लैब नहीं थी, वॉलंटियर्स नहीं थे सर्वे करने के लिए, रिसर्च का कोई मटेरियल नहीं था. पीपल 200 किलोमीटर्स अवे डिडंट न्यू ईच अदर, दे डिडंट मैट ईच अदर. आई एम टॉकिंग ऑफ थिंग्स 500 इयर्स बैक. हाउ डिड दिस लेवल ऑफ थिंकिंग ऑफ सोशल बिहेवियर्स, रिलेशनशिप्स and high human living come in the mind, and that they could express in words beautifully in their works? That means they broke the eye barrier, and the amrut, the nectar of big thinking, sprouted out. So keep your eyes small, because for whichever thing you are keeping your eye big, there is a person right besides you who has a bigger possession of that particular asset to break your eye. Tell me yes or no. Simple. You have the right to keep big eye only if you have decided, and only if you have the power, and only if you have, by exercising that power, you have won over life and death. मृत्यु पे अगर आपका विजय हो गया है तो आपको आय रखने की इजाजत है. Who knows tomorrow morning I'm going to get up? Just raise his hands. 1.5 lakh people live this earth every day. Out of them 8,000 they don't open their eyes in the morning. 8,000 लोग रात को एक कार्यक्रम पूरा. उनमें से कभी भी हो सकता है. तो वाई टू कीप दैट आई? एंड टाइम हैज द पावर. इफ यू डोंट गो बाय थिंकिंग देन बाय पावर इट हैज इट्स ओन वेज टू रिड्यूस योर आई टू एशेस. इवन इफ यू आर अ पर्सन ऑफ 12,000 करोड़, यू कैन गो इन टू अ रेंटेड फ्लैट. एनीबडी. Even if you are the Sahara of thousands of families, you can still lie be Sahara in Tihar. Anybody's eye gets crushed anytime. Why to keep it? Even if you are the king of the skies, you have to leave India without an Indian passport. Yes or no? Even if you are changing three-piece suits 3 times a day by being the chairman, rather the executive chairman of Satyam, you are in prison, that is behind the bars, wearing a prisoner's clothes and sleeping on a mattress. Time has the power to reduce anybody's eye to ashes. Yes or no?
Yes.
Then why not think intelligently, think wisely, and reduce that eye? हमारे गुरु योगी जी महाराज, जो प्रमुख स्वामी महाराज के गुरु थे, वो बहुत एक अच्छी बात करते थे. एज आई टोल्ड यू द ग्रेट सेंट पोएट्स, द विजडम दैट दे हैव गिवन टू अस. व्हेन आई वाज टॉकिंग टू आई एम स्टूडेंट्स इन बैंगलोर अबाउट 3-5 months बैक, आई चैलेंज देम एट द एंड ऑफ द टॉक दैट एनी रिसर्च फ्रॉम द वेस्ट व्हेन इट कम्स टू सोशल रिलेशनशिप्स और बेटर ह्यूमन लिविंग, you bring it to me and I'll put a fine verse of some of the same poets of India against it, that this was exactly said 300 years back, 400 years back, 500 years back. But wo kya hai, when it comes from the saffron cloth, you feel that theek hai, in logo ko to aur kya danda hai, bolte hai, baat karte rehte hai. But when it comes from a three-piece suit and a collar mic and walking on the stage and expressing himself in a more cultured manner, and you pay a 5,000 or a 10,000 rupee per delegate fee, then you feel that he's talking something. और वही बात अगर हम लोग करें, ठीक है, चलता रहता है, इन लोगों तो सुबह से शाम क्या धंधा है, करते रहते होंगे, सुबह भी बोलते हैं, शाम को भी बोलते रहते हैं. लेकिन मैंने बोला नहीं कि फॉर बेटर ह्यूमन लिविंग, फॉरगेट साइंटिफिक डिस्कवरीज, इन्वेंशंस आर अदर पार्ट ऑफ द स्टोरी,
for better human living, anything that is being researched, surveyed, or experimentally proved is well written by the saint poets of India centuries ago. I was talking of Yogeshi Maharaj. He said, wonderful example, that when the rivers get flooded and the water gushes into the localities, the iron poles, big trees, and even the buildings, they fall. But when the water recedes, you will find the small grass standing at its place as it is. He used to say this. Very intelligently put, very wisely put, but a very apt example. Then he used to ask why. Because when the gushing waters would come, the pole or the tree or the building would try to stand because of their strong foundation, because of that I have a strong foundation and nothing happens to me. This is an example, huh? That is, I have a strong foundation, nothing happens to me, and so it gets flooded with the water. And the humble little grass immediately bends. And the water goes above its head, and after the water recedes, it stands back, laughing at the huge buildings. I'm here, okay? This is to exemplify that nobody's eye stands. So, before time slaps you to reduce your eye to ashes, wisely thinking, you reduce it, then the big thinking starts in your life. And you will start enjoying your life much better. Much better. And when you start thinking big and wisely, what happens to you? What advantage you get into? Once Pramukh Swami Maharaj in 1991 here in Dadar temple was interviewed by Harkishan Mehta. He was then the chief editor of Janmabhumi Pravasi. Harkishan Mehta, Mohan Bhai must be knowing him personally. Chitralekha. So Harkishan Mehta asked wonderful practical questions to Pramukh Swami. The first question asked was, he said, Swamiji, you are doing wonderful work for the society, selflessly, to this scale. But if somebody criticizes you or speaks foul for you, then? Pramukh Swami immediately responded that we remain least concerned about that. Only when somebody criticizes us, we close our eyes, get into a mode of introspection and think that, are we right in the eyes of God? Are we right ethically? Are we right in the hearts of people? If we get a yes answer, we don't bother about the criticism. Immediately Harkishan Mehta asked, but then if the criticizer is right then? Sorry, if the criticizer is wrong then? Then Pramukh Swami said, if he is wrong, we have never gone to answer him. We just pray for him that God gives him the right understanding. This is called big thinking. Aapki 20 saal ki friendship kisi ke saath todana hai. So it takes me only 5 minutes. Huh? And it takes only 5 minutes for you also. To break somebody's 20 or 30. Year 30 year relationship. You know how? The most poisonous words and the most deadly words upon this earth are tane khabar se tujhe pata hai tujhe namane nahi khabar khare khare nahi khabar, you know, making the material more spicy. Khorekhor tane khabar nahi. And the third sentence is more deadly. Hun tane kau pan tare maru naam nahi devan. Hava tame bada hasya kem mane kau. Sailesh bhai bada vatti uttar aapi dido ke apda badu kariye chhe. And pehla pan tane interested thi jaye. Em? Sukidu. He said this, X, Y, Z, A, B, C about this, you. Then the questioner starts from our side. Kon hatu? Okay, he was there. પેલું શું બોલ્યું, પેલાએ શું કીધું, પેલાએ શું બોલ્યું. 70% જિંદગીનો કોન્શિયસ ટાઈમ આ સાંભળવામાં અને વિચારવામાં જતો રહે છે. આમાં રાઈટ થિંકિંગ, બિગ થિંકિંગ ક્યાં આવે? All great personalities were never concerned of what people opined for them. They were always concerned for only three things when they made judgments in their lives, or when they started a process, or where they in the midst of some working. Am I right in God's eyes? Tick. Am I right ethically? Tick. Am I right in people's heart in the way that I'm doing good for the people and their acceptance of my good? If these three are ticks, then don't worry about any process. This is called big thinking. એને મને આવું કીધું છે ને, એટલે હવે આવો પ્રસંગ બીજી વાર આવે ને, 10 વર્ષ રાહ જોયો, ફરી વખત એવો લગ્ન પ્રસંગ આવે અને ફરી વખત એ ગ્રુપ ભેગું થાય, પ્રમુખ સ્વામી યુઝ ટુ વેરી જોકિંગલી સે, રાધર લાફિંગલી સે, કે બે ભાઈઓ વચ્ચે ઝઘડો થાય ને, એક ભાઈ કે તને જોઈ લઈશ, તો આ 20 વર્ષ સુધી કર્યું શું, જોયું તો તને, આ 20 વર્ષ સુધી આપણે બે ભેગા રહ્યા ત્યાં સુધી મને જોયો જ નહોતો, હું તને ઓળખું છું તો અત્યારે ખબર પડી, અત્યાર સુધી ઓળખતો નહોતો. બિગ થિંકિંગ ડઝન્ટ કમ ટુ યુ દેટ વે. સો ધીસ આર ધ બેઝિક ફંડાસ દેટ વી નીડ ટુ ક્લિયર ઇન લાઈફ. Never be proud about anything, because that can come down to ashes in the test of time. Prithvipati raja hota aaj ni kabaro kya se koi ne khabar nahi. Those people who would put their feet on the ground and the ground would shake, they were powerful share bazar na manas hota hata ke nahi, ke je logo if they sneeze Wall Street would catch fever. That powerful people. Those people who could pick up a telephone sitting on the 50th floor of a Manhattan building and topple a government in Africa just by one phone call. This powerful people. Many of them are behind bars. Many of them have gone bankrupt. Many of them have become very paupers. And many of them have lived a very miserable last years of their life. ટાઈમ પાસે બહુ પાવર છે. એ પહેલા આપણે વિઝડમથી આપણું રાઈટ થિંકિંગ કરવું. ઓલ ધ પેલેસીસ ઓલ ઓવર ધ વર્લ્ડ આર એમ્પ્ટી. ઓલ ધ પેલેસીસ ઓલ ઓવર ધ વર્લ્ડ આર એમ્પ્ટી, મતલબ દે આર નોટ ઇનહેબિટેડ ટુડે બાય ધ ઓરિજિનલ ડિસેન્ડન્ટ્સ ઓફ ધ રોયલ ફેમિલી. આ વિચારવાનું, એટલે આઈ ઓછો થઈ જાય, I also think that gives you the right to big thinking. This is called consciousness. This is called alertness. We talked of Kalam. We talked of Pramukh Swami Maharaj. These people rose to this level because they dissolved their I, and that is how sprouted out the right to think big. They got this advantage. So when you think big, another big practical advantage that I want to tell you today is, you will not have a confrontational style of dealing with people. You will develop a style of developing consensus while working. Not confrontational, but consensus. This is the biggest right that you exercise of big thinking, and this is called internal democracy. Not confrontational, but consensus. That is the way you developed. And then whatever you see, wherever you see, you get into the highest mode of thinking. When 2002, September 24th was the day when terrorists attacked Akshardham in Gandhinagar. The whole incident happened. After a few days, Pramukh Swami Maharaj himself visited the place and he sprinkled pious water at all the places where the innocent people were killed. Then the saint said, Swami, we have visited all the places, let's go back to our residence. Pramukh Swami said, where those two people who had come from outside were killed by the NSG? He said, Swami, that was there, under that tree. Pramukh Swami, we said, we want to go there. Pramukh Swami went there. He sprinkled the same pious water with a good wish and a prayer at that place where the two terrorists were killed in the morning by the NSG. with prayers, that never ever such thought enters anybody's mind. This is called high thinking. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam writes this in this book, Transcendence. He mentions this incident. And he comes out with another good type of high thinking and good thinking and big thinking from this incident. Pramukh Swami came up with a big thinking that he went there also and sprinkled pious water for the good of their souls also. But Abdul Kalam sprouted up again a good idea that Pramukh Swami went there to sprinkle the pious water at the place where the two terrorists were killed, and he gave a message to the world that every human life is sacred. What a thinking! Every human life is pious. Every human life is sacred. ज्यादा तो पता नहीं चले समाज में, लेकिन घर में जो साथ में रहते उतना तो समझ लो कि every human life is pious. तो भी जो 65% cases भारत की courts में चल रहे हैं, the mother-in-law, daughter-in-law cases, उसमें कुछ सुधार आए. मैं कई बार jokingly कहता हूँ कि उसको mother-in-law, daughter-in-law, in-laws इसलिए कहते हैं, because they are destined and privileged to draw you towards law, so they are called in-law. इसलिए उसको in-law बोलते हैं. Destined to take you there, drag you there. Okay, lighter moments apart, but telling you this is, कई problems solve हो जाते हैं. Every human life is sacred. Every human life is pious. What a big thinking. And that is why Kalam became People's President. And that is why he was honored with 48 doctorate degrees from 48 universities in 30 different countries. Still, people wanted to take the credit that Kalam has been offered doctorate honorary from our university. That's a privilege from our university. They were offering him that, and he would say, now I'm quite old, I don't have the time and the energy to come there, please. And still they would confer him in his absence and send the degrees and everything at his place. Because the universities wanted to take the privilege that Dr. Kalam is one of honorary doctorates from our university. And some of us, we are living such a life that even our neighbors don't want them, us, besides them. हमारे कहीं neighbors इसते हैं कि exact words बोली गया दिनेश भाई, जाए तो साधु. And people used to confer these degrees to Kalam. Kalam was not a billionaire. Was he? After coming out, while coming out from the presidential palace, he had just two briefcases. In one briefcase was his three pairs of clothes. Second briefcase was his books and material. And bole ke, sir, saman andar pada hai? Kalam, nahin, yehi saman hai. Presidential palace mein se bahar nikalte waqt itna hi saman tha. And so he writes in this book, Transcendence. Sorry, in the book, Ignited Minds. He writes, that of my 80 years of living, I have learned one principle. And then he writes, now I'm quoting him not just word to word, but letter to letter. He writes that I found out that simple living is the best form of free life, full of freedom, full of righteousness, and full of realization. Simple living, we have attached simple living and high thinking is an extension of it. Actually, simple living itself is high thinking. They are not two, they are not separate, they are the same thing. Only a person who has gone beyond a certain levels of eyes and big thinking, only he has the power to live simple. Simple living needs tremendous amount of mental power. And the top 500 personalities decided by United Nations as the best ever 500 people who walked upon this earth ever. If you go through the list, none of them were such who ever wore branded clothes in their life or branded shoes in their life. So tailors don't make man, character makes a man. This is called high thinking. Because we don't have high thinking, we need branded clothes and branded shoes and better looks and, you know, to show people that I'm something. Kalam was asked, why long hairs? He said, I don't get enough time to cut the hairs. Narendra Modi was asked, why half sleeve kurtas? Because that was new. Kurtas are normally full sleeve. He said that I had extensive traveling as RSS Pracharak. So my briefcase was very small. My baggage was so small that it did not have enough space that if I have full sleeve kurtas, I could fold and get into it. And actually that was taking more of water and more of soap to get to wash it. So I cut it myself, he said this. I cut the sleeves myself so that janjat come. People who have reached a certain level, they have certain level of thinking. Forget the resources. Resources will not get you long. Thinking will get you long. Actually, resources are an obstacle for your big thinking. Those people who are born with silver spoon, they carry on with the silver and the golden spoon. Their brains don't develop. I tell it confidently. Those people who are born with silver or golden spoons, or many of them even with platinum spoons, their brains remain copper and iron. They don't develop. Because bachpan se ye sab vyavasthaye mil gayi, maan sanman mil gaya, pratishtha mil gayi, riches mil gaye, Mercedes mil gayi. So the minds don't develop. Minds develop when the resources are less, step ahead, when you don't crave for resources. Resources, high thinking ke saath, aisa hi aate hain. Hamare Guru Shastri Ji Maharaj ek achhi baat karte the, jinhone Pramukh Sahib Maharaj ko diksha di thi. That when you buy a bull or a cow from a farmer, and you take it after paying the money, you don't have to pay for the flies who are there stuck on the body of the cow. Simple example of such great sayings. By that he meant that if you go for high thinking, big thinking, you will not have to carry or worry for the resources like the bugs or the flies on the body of the cow or the bull that you have purchased. As you go along with it, the flies come along with it, resource will be dragged behind such high thinking. You don't have to worry for it. The I think Steve Jobs gave, the iPhone, the iPad, and the iPod, thinking. And that made Apple $1,400 revenue company, $1,400 billion, which is more than the GDP of more than 160 countries individually.
Even the I is smaller than the iPhone.
Even the iPhone has a smaller I. Here, we must give him a big hand. Very good. I will quote this in my next talk somewhere. This is what happened to Abdul Kalam when he was talking in Anand. He writes this in his book, Ignited Minds, that I was talking to students and I asked a very simple question to grade 10, 11, 12 students, and I asked them, who is your biggest enemy? And a small little girl, she was in standard 9, she raised her hand and she said, sir, can I answer? And Abdul Kalam said, yes. And she said, sir, our biggest enemy is poverty. Abdul Kalam was so much fascinated by this answer. You read his autobiography, The Ignited Minds. On the first page, he mentioned this particular incident. He mentions it and he writes underneath that I dedicate this book, Ignited Minds, to that little girl of Anand. So I'll dedicate my next talk to him. That doesn't mean I'm a Kalam, I'm a small person. But then we are trying to tread the path of the great Mahajano Yem Gatahasa Panthaha. We always try to tread the path, treaded by the great. This is how you become. So that is great thinking. That it gives. Kalam presented his idea to Pramukh Swami Maharaj and said, by 2020, when we want to make India a superpower, I have decided with my team to work upon principal 5 areas by which, the results of which can make India superpower. Then he said the first is health and education. Second is agriculture. Third is information and communication. Fourth is infrastructure. And fifth is critical technology. And he humbly asked Pramukh Swami, because already he had experienced something in his presence, Swamiji, do you would like to add or alter something? And Pramukh Swami said, yes. Add the sixth element, faith in humanity and faith in God. And he adds this, that these six departments we need to work. And Pramukh Swami came up with a logical reason for adding the sixth element. He said, with the best of institutes and infrastructure that you have, but if the worst of humans, then 1 lakh crore, 1.5 lakh crore, 2 lakh crore, directly on the government coffers. Corruption. Best of institutes, they have gone rotten because they did not get the right kind of person at the top. Isn't it? The right kind of person at the top comes when he has faith in humanity, he has faith in values, and he has faith in God. And he added the sixth element. He added it, expressed it beautifully, and used to talk. Even when in his last talk at Shillong, he mentioned this incident. I heard the audio of it because it was just half talk. He got a massive cardiac arrest while he was standing on the podium in front of his students. But that half speech, I've heard, I especially like worked hard to get that. And I got it, fortunately, he has mentioned this. So this comes from it. This is called high thinking, big thinking. And you enjoy life. Once you get into the mode of thinking big and wisely, you are in the least expectation of companies, resources, and somebody helping me out. Somebody I need to spend my evening. Something I need to take myself forward. If they are there, fine. If they are not there, very fine. The day you are able to live with your own thoughts, you have reached the zenith of existence. You don't need any expectations. यार वो मित्र ने कहीं दिनों से फोन नहीं किया, बिजी होगा, अगर तेरी इच्छा है तो फोन कर ले, लेकिन कहीं दिनों से क्यों फोन नहीं किया वो विचार कभी नहीं आएगा. यू गो इन टू दैट मोड दैट यू आर एबल टू लीव हैप्पीली विथ योर ओन थॉट प्रोसेसेस. इन द मिड्स ऑफ पीपल, फाइन. अलोन, फाइन. व्हाई वाज आई नॉट इनवाइटेड टू द पार्टी? फाइन. इनवाइटेड, गुड. Not invited, more good. You are able to live with your own thought processes and live happily. Varna to ye samaj mein roj aise prasang bante hain. Din mein, hamare Guru Yogi Ji Maharaj kehte hain, din mein 10 baar. In his traditional Gujarati, he used to say, divas mein 10 baar, divel pidela mota thi jaye. Thi jaye, divas mein 10 baar. When you are in the mode of high thinking, big thinking, it's a wise state of existence of your mind. And that wise state is, happenings you accept gracefully. Situations you accept gracefully. And people coming in your life, living your life, you accept gracefully. It's a good state of mind. I normally teach the 60-20-10-10 principle of relationships and work. 60% of the people that you develop relationships with will remain with you lifetime. Another 20% of the people that you have in your life, you will have to pay a high maintenance value to keep that relationship alive. Pumping a lot of resources. Bar bar maan dena padta hai, bar bar bulana padta hai. You know, keeping a message every third day. Good morning, kaisa hai? Some relationships, they need a high maintenance value. Huh? That comes to 60 plus 20 is 80. Another 10% of the relationships of your life are bound to get spoiled. Chinta mat karna. This is everybody's story. 7 million population upon this earth. And the last 10% of the relationships are bound to get converted into enmity, if not enmity, severe competition or envy. So when a relationship breaks, give 3 chances to it every 2 months for 6 months. If it doesn't rejoin, say a very big bye, wish him or her good, pray for him, turn around your face, and most importantly, don't forget to delete his number from your mobile.
So, बार बार आप स्क्रॉल करो और वो नाम आए तो चिंता यार इसने मेरे साथ ऐसा किया वो 10% वाला था तेरे साथ जो ऐसा किया वो 10+10 वाला था वो रिलेशनशिप था दिस 60-20-10-10 इज एवरीबडी स्टोरी नाउ इंट्रोस्पेक्ट यस और नो
यस
और नो
देन
व्हाई टू वरी अबाउट इट देन यू हैव नथिंग टू वरी एवरीथिंग टू एंजॉय So this is called big thinking. This is called right thinking. We are potentially capable of doing it, but we are not exercising the right effect. We need to exercise that potential power that we have within. Because a man at the end of the day and at the end of his life is a bundle of his thoughts. Whatever you thought for the whole day, you are in the evening. Whatever you thought for the whole of your life, you are at the end of your life, 60, 70, 80 years, when you are there at that stage. So man at the end of his day, at the end of his life, is a bundle of his thoughts. Why not to keep that high? Why not to keep that big? Then you will enjoy life. That gives you power of it. Actually, as I say, we are potentially capable. This is written in the scriptures. Vayam amrutasya putraha. We are the children of God. We are the children of God. There is a real life story that a princess, her age must be like 7 or 8. And she was very naughty, indisciplined, going around. And you know, that she did not behave according to the dignity of the royal family. And this was at that time in the 18th century in the British royal family. So her mother, her father, everybody were concerned about. They had a tutor for her. And the tutor was also trying to devise ways for her to have that dignity of behavior according to the royal legacy that she was in. And then she devised a way that she designed a bookmarker for all her textbooks, all her homework books, and that bookmarker read one sentence, that I am the 8th in the succession to the British throne. What the bookmarker read? I am the 8th in succession to the British throne. This little girl would repeatedly read that sentence again and again. Within 4-5 months, the big thinking started. Then I belong to royal family. In future, I'm going to be the queen. I need to walk, talk, think in a royal, dignified way with myself, with people, with situations and circumstances around me. Change their life. So we are potentially capable of big thinking. Sometimes we need an injection from outside. And today's talk is for that. To get a big injection from... You get a big injection from outside. Another big thinking that has been given to us by the great seers and well accepted by the Western thinkers is that the basic fundamental thought, we are not this human body, we are the soul. Hum atma hai, hum deh nahi hai. Even science says that you are not a single cell what you were 5 years back. 5 saal mein har koi kosh sharir mein badal jata hai. What you were 5 years back, you are not a single cell today. That means something is constantly changing. Don't take this as a super spiritual understanding. This is a very practical understanding. It helps us a lot. When Pramukh Swami Maharaj was insulted non-stop for 1 hour by a cabinet minister, he was at that time the member of the Planning Commission of India. I would not hesitate now to name him because Pramukh Swami Maharaj is no longer upon this earth. His name
Yogendra Makwana. Yes. He insulted Pramukh Swami Maharaj for 1 hour. Pramukh Swami Maharaj at that time was at Paramanand Bhai's place. And Rajni Bhai knows it well, that incident right from that time of happening. And the principal reason of insulting Pramukh Swami constantly for 1 hour was that you are initiating young boys who are educationally qualified, doctors, engineers, chartered accountants, into same fold. This is not right for the society. In future, there will be scarcity of chartered accountants, doctors, and engineers in society. Arey bhai, jitne abhi hai, usko to pehle job do. Pramukh Swami did not say a single word. 3 times in between that 1 hour session, one of our elder Sadhguru saints, Pujya Vivek Sagar Swami, tried to interrupt and Pramukh Swami hold his hand and said, "Emne je kya hue kya baat?" At that time, Pramukh Swami Maharaj was under fever, 101 degree temperature. This gentleman did not have even that thinking that at this moment I should not say these words to a person who is sick. Forget that level. In front of him was a person who was widely accepted by the society for his all types of social works for the benefit of humanity, Pramukh Swami Maharaj himself. And he did this. After that 1 hour, and when somebody starts scolding you, and you stand in front of him with eyes into his eyes, without repelling him, it is a natural process that he repeats all his throwing on you 2 or 3 times. He did it. After 1 hour, when he was exhausted with all the words, Pramukh Swami just looked at the wall clock. It was 12:30 p.m. And Pramukh Swami Maharaj asked Pujya Vivek Sagar Swami, "It's lunch time. Please arrange for him for lunch." "Sir, how many people are you?" He said, "3. Swami asked for 3 dishes and arranged for his lunch. Now, this happened in 1985-86. 3 years hence, in 1988, he was no more the cabinet minister. He was no more the planning commission member. And for some reason, for some wrong happening, he was discarded from even the primary membership of the national party that he was representing. His own party. Pramukh Swami Maharaj was in Nairobi. In 1988, his 68th birthday celebrations were there. This gentleman had gone to Nairobi for a fundraising drive of his own social project, of his own foundation. He came to know that there is going to be a large gathering of Indians in the presence of Pramukh Swami. He came to that gathering. Pramukh Swami Maharaj was informed that he has come. Pramukh Swami Maharaj knew that now this man is nothing. He doesn't hold any power, position, prestige in the society. Even then, Pramukh Swami Maharaj, when he saw him coming, he stood up from the dais. Pramukh Swami was in the center stage of the whole dais. An assembly of 5,000, 7,000 people sitting in front of him. It was his birthday celebrations. And the dais was packed by who's who of Kenya. Pramukh Swami rose from his chair, walked towards the edge of the stage, asked the gentleman to come up. Yogendra Makwana said, "Swami, I'm here, comfortable." Swami caught hold of his hand, brought him on the dais, introduced him as a good social worker and an ex-minister to all the guests on the dais, made him sit beside him, and for his project, Pramukh Swami personally appealed for a fundraising drive in his speech at the end of the assembly. Yogendra Makwana was in tears that what I did to this man 3 years back. At that time, I had power, position, prestige. Today, I don't possess that. Even at that time, Pramukh Swami Maharaj could exhibit this highest level of human dignity. This is called big thinking and big living. I think you are all touched by this incident. I could read from your faces, from your eyes. Living up to the highest standards of human dignity under any circumstances is the highest, best expression of big thinking. We must never forget that we are potentially divine for big thinking. Forget the animal instincts. उसने मुझे ये कहा था, अब मैं देख लूँगा। वो तो कुत्ते भी स्ट्रीट्स पे करते हैं। वो तो जंगल में पशु भी करते हैं। और आप कंक्रीट बिल्डिंग्स में एसी चैम्बर में बैठ के अगर यही निम्न विचारधारा रखोगे तो आप में और कुत्ते में फर्क क्या? We are designed for high thinking, for big thinking. Another good big thinking, I'm in the last stage of my talk. Another big thinking is that to have absolute peace and stability in your life. How much do you want? How much of you want absolute peace and stability in your life? Just raise your hands. We all. I give you just one pill for it. That pill, once a day, and whenever the circumstances arise. But diabetes mein kya hota hai? Kuch subah mein le lete hain. Aur fir, jab bhi sugar kam jyada hui, Yesterday, day before yesterday, we were in Nasik. And at that time, we met a gentleman. He came up to me and said, Swami, bring some sweet for me. I immediately understood that his sugar level has gone down. I asked a volunteer. I also ran out of my room and got something for him. So this pill that I'm giving you for big thinking is going to be very useful whenever a situation arises. Jab bhi sugar down ya up ho jaye. Kaun si sugar? Animal instinct ki. Animal instincts ki sugar down ya up ho jaye, us waqt ye pill lena. Aur regular roz subah ek to le hi lena. Wo pill kya hai? God is the all doer. Whatever happens in my life happens with the wish of God, happens for my good, and happens for my progress if I keep this right attitude. Mere jeevan mein jo kuch ban raha hai, wo Bhagwan ki ichha se ho raha hai. Mere achhe ke liye ho raha hai. Aur main agar ye vichar rakhunga, to isme meri pragati hai. Pramukh Swami Maharaj was asked the essence of his 95 year of wisdom filled life. And he said this, Bhagwan ne karta harta manwa. It's not that you don't apply all your resources to come out of a bad situation. You have to apply. That is a human endeavor. That is a human effort. But the understanding that you need to keep at this time to maintain peace within and to maintain stability in your life is this understanding that definitely a wrong situation has propped up in my life. Something wrong, very has gone in my life. I will definitely try to come out of it, but while coming out of it, going through the process, keep this understanding, it's God's wish, God is going to teach me something, He's opening a new way for me, it's a dark tunnel, but at the end of the dark tunnel, there is definitely going to be light. With that hope, with that faith, I'm going to move ahead, applying the resources that I have. This is called big thinking. This is called big thinking. Otherwise, you will get depressed, bogged down. And human dignity and human living is how did you handle failures of your life? Achhi situation mein to hum sab king aur queen hi hai. Conducive atmosphere mein we are all kings and queens. Pratikul paristhiti khadi hui jeevan mein us waqt dignity levels kam hue ya bade? That is important. One of my very good friends, he is a giant executive with a multinational corporation. His annual pay is 20 crores. He is a Southeast Asia head of a American corporation. I was sitting, we got friendly at an event that we met. We were all there sitting together, the host introduced us and we became friendly and we are good friends even today. Once we were sitting, I just wanted to know more about that kind of execution of works. Because a person who gets 20 crore per annum as pay, he has some responsibilities and some execution obligations. I asked him a very simple question. I said, people of your caliber, if they go as candidates for an interview for a job, what are you people asked? किसी को 10,000 की जॉब की चपरासी की जॉब आपको देंगे तो आप क्या पूछेंगे, 8 बजे आ जाना है, आ जाएगा ना? तो कहाँ आ जाऊंगा, 5 बजे तक रहना है ना? हाँ सर रहूंगा। ठीक है टिफिन लेके आना है? तो क्या हाँ सर। आई कार्ड क्या है? हाँ इसकी एक जेरॉक्स करवा लो। एंड ही गेट्स रिक्रूटेड। 20 करोड़ और प्लस, 50 करोड़, 100 करोड़ की जॉब, व्हेन दे गो फॉर दैट जॉब इंटरव्यू व्हाट आर दे आस्क्ड? Because already they have experience of handling an employee force of 10,000, 15,000, 20,000. Already they know what are infrastructure, systems, managements and HRs. Already they know what is 15,000 crore and 20,000 crore turnovers. They know everything. They've been handling this since 15 years, 20 years. So I asked him, what are they asked in interview? And who are the people who interview them? Very important. And the first answer that Swami, the people who interview them are of course the bosses of the company, because they have the natural right to interview. They are the executive chairman or the owner of the business or whatever, or a big stakeholder, whatever. I said fine. What are they asked? Then he said, these people in their interviews, they are asked only one question, and they are supposed to answer it for 1 hour long. I said, what is that? That felt me more interesting. He said, they are asked only one question, and the question is, describe the biggest failure and setback of your life, and how did you deal with it? Start the story. And only when the interviewers find in the answers of his that he has not put aside human dignity while coming out of that bad shape of his life or a severe setback or fall, he is recruited for the job. क्योंकि ये कक्षा के लोगों को ये नहीं पूछना है कि अगर आपका हमारे सेल्स जर्मनी में बढ़ाना है तो क्या करेंगे? Already has 1,000 better ideas than the interviewer. He is only questioned one thing, कि अगर कोई grave situation खड़ी हो गई तो आप क्या करने वाले हो, वो उसके आइडिया से पता इनको करना है। अगर कुछ बड़ा लॉस आ गया कंपनी को तो हाउ वुड यू थिंक एंड बिहेव? सिंपल। सो द ओनली क्वेश्चन इज डिस्क्राइब अ बिग रादर द बिगेस्ट फेलियर एंड सेटबैक ऑफ योर लाइफ एंड हाउ डिड यू कम आउट ऑफ इट? स्टार्ट द स्टोरी। 1 hour। द ओनली चेक वेदर ही हैज मिस्ड आउट ऑन ह्यूमन डिग्निटी और नॉट, दैट इज बिग थिंकिंग और नॉट। If he has not missed out on it, he is picked up. If he has missed out on it, he is left out. So by your best academics, best talents, best experiences, you can break a certain barrier. But beyond that barrier, only your big thinking can take you to that levels. That's a different level of living. And that, as I said, doesn't come by materialistic resources or privileges. Every human mind is potentially designed to do it. That God is the doer. Sarva karta harta Bhagwan hai. God is the all doer, and whatever happens in my life happens for my good, for my progress. Bhagwan ne karta harta janwa. This was the biggest strength of Pramukh Swami's life. I am opening a secret of Pramukh Swami's life. Opening the secret of his peace and stability that he enjoyed for 95 years. And be careful when I am talking to you and listening, you, that is you listening it, that Pramukh Swami, he was the president of this worldwide BAPS organization for 65 years. Undisputed. Unchallenged. No voting. And we loved from the bottom of our hearts that he remains our president lifetime. He remained the spiritual guru of this organization for 45 years. Give me one organization that you know who has its president for even 5 years. Har 2-3 saal mein elections hote hain. So naya president aata hai, first year mein kaam karta hai, second year mein responses, supports kam milne lagte hain kyunki सभा प्रकृति बाहर आ जाती है, और थर्ड ईयर को पॉलिटिकल प्लानिंग में ही जाता है। Whoever's back you slap is everybody's back. हर एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में ये होता है. इमेजिन वी BAPSR ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, you have heard of Lions International, you have heard of Rotary International. BAPS is that level of organization. We have got a permanent seat in the United Nations as an NGO. We are that big organization with a presence in more than 60 countries. आपने दादर का एक मंदिर देखा है ना? अच्छा अक्षरधाम तो देखा है ना, गुजरात में या दिल्ली में. ऐसे छोटे मोटे 1500 कैंपस इन 60 कंट्रीज, वन मैन शो प्रमुख स्वामी महाराज, वन मैन शो. अलॉन्ग विद दैट 200 हॉस्पिटल्स, स्कूल्स, हॉस्टल्स एंड कॉलेजेस. ही बिल्ड इट एंड सक्सेसफुली एडमिनिस्टर्ड इट. In future, Pramukh Swami's management will be taught in the best B schools of the world. Our generation will see. Dekhna. Take these words from me today. So, unke jeevan ka ek rahasya, the key of his good living, the key of the peace and stability that he enjoyed. Main isliye kehta hu ki itni badi sanstha hoti hai, itne bade samuday mein kaam karna. आप जो कॉर्पोरेशंस में काम करते हो, कंपनी में, वहां आपका काम है पे एंड स्माइल. यू पे मनी टू योर एम्प्लॉय एंड देयर इज अ स्माइल ऑन हिज फेस बिकॉज ही लाइक्स योर पे, एंड देयर इज अ स्माइल ऑन योर फेस एज अ बॉस ऑफ द कंपनी बिकॉज यू आर लाइकिंग हिज वर्क. इसलिए परस्पर एक दूसरे के चेहरे पे स्मित है. इन एनजीओस लाइक अस इट इज सर्व एंड स्माइल रिलेशनशिप. यू हैव टू सर्व एंड स्माइल. I don't have any bank account, no saints has. I don't charge a single rupee for my talks. Shailesh bhai, am I right or wrong? Paisa nahi bolta. In 24 years, I have not charged anything. This is my humble service to society. I don't have a bank account. I have had the same clothes since 25 years. And the same way of living. The same style, the same color. ये आपको सामान्य लगता होगा, आप एक कलर का एक ही ड्रेस एक वीक तक पहनने की कोशिश करना, फिर पता चलेगा संत का एक प्रथम छोटा सा महिमा तब पता चलेगा. छोटा सा एक ही कलर का एक ही ड्रेस एक वीक तक तो पहनो, आपको लगेगा यार कुछ हो रहा है. कुछ हो नहीं रहा है, सब कुछ यही हो रहा है. बट डू यू सी एनी सैडनेस ऑन माई फेस? I don't have a bank account. I don't have a family. I don't have a house. I don't have third pair of clothes, only two pairs. If I don't wash my pair today, it's difficult what to wear the next morning. And still, can you see any lesser joy on my face? The reason is two things. Atmanishtha or Kartartha. Biggest thought of human living. I am not this human body, I am the soul. And Bhagwan karta hai. This is the biggest thing. The proof that you are living high, thinking big, is that if you are the combination of the honesty of a child, the energy of a youth, and the maturity of an adult. These three combined together, and it is called big thinking. It is called high living. आप ये प्रवचन कितना समझे? लेट मी चेक आउट. आई आस्क यू वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन. बी फेथफुल टू योर सेल्फ वाइल थिंकिंग एंड वाइल आंसरिंग. इफ योर पार्टनर डिसअग्रीज विथ यू ऑन एन इंपॉर्टेंट प्रोजेक्ट दैट इज वेरी क्लोज टू योर हार्ट, व्हाट वुड यू थिंक ऑफ योर पार्टनर? Partner means both life and business. I give you 10-15 seconds to think. What if your partner absolutely disagrees with you, is exactly on the opposite end of the table? Or for a project or a work which is very dear and near to your heart, and the partner is both life partner and business partner. Just raise your hands if you want to. Just raise. After about 10 seconds, just raise your hands. I want to see how many hands are raised. Yes, Neeraj? What would you think?
Maybe I would get disturbed that I'm not able to put my point across and convince.
I'm not able to put my point across and convince my partner, and you will feel disturbed. This is an absolutely normal human behavior, happens with everybody. Anybody having an opinion or a stand other than this, Ajay? Okay, 6-9 relay, the 6-9 theory.
What she will think, why she, we are C or E? Why you don't agree with my point?
Okay, whatever, you step inside the partner's shoes. That is the 6-9 formula. You say it's 6 written on the floor, and somebody standing on the other side, he says it's 9. Both are right.
Yeah.
And you know, the story is only half here. It is said that you have to go there and see the person's viewpoint. And then you have to say, yes, what you were saying was right, it is 9. But don't forget the second half of the story. Catch his or her hand and bring them in your position also. Both are important. But the first, take an initiative from your side to go into their shoes. But don't forget to bring them in your shoes also. And then you come on a CMP, Common Minimum Program. Another good question. How do you take the wounds of your life, the hurts of your life? How do you view it at that moment and a few years down the line? The hurts and wounds of your life. Sabko when? The hurts and wounds of your life. How do you look at it? Just raise your hands if you have some thinking. I'll ask you. I'll give you another 10 seconds for it.
That's past.
That's past. Good thing.
Self-learning.
Kada destiny as and forget it. Abdul Kalam writes, yes, you gentlemen in the back. Yes, you. White t-shirt.
God's will.
God's will. Good. You accepted my last point. That's good. But then you accepted it because you must have had some basic thinking of it. Otherwise, it's difficult. This is a very big thought.
I tried to find out what fault I had.
Yeah. In that any bad happening, what fault I had at that time? What was wrong from my side? Wound is wisdom. Kalam writes in Ignited Minds, wounds are wisdom. जो घाव यहाँ पहुँचे हैं, जो दर्द यहाँ पहुँचा है, वो wisdom है. दो प्रकार की wisdom. Never to repeat that mistake again. And second, level of acceptance has gone high. Acceptance is a big wisdom. Acceptance is a big wisdom. एक और क्वेश्चन मेरे मन में आता है. हाउ यू टेक योर सेल्फ और हाउ यू कंडक्ट योर सेल्फ इन द वेटिंग फेज ऑफ योर लाइफ. वेटिंग फेज कहां आते हैं? अकेडमिकली क्वालिफाइड हुए, अभी जॉब नहीं मिल रही है. मैनेजेबल एज में आ गए, स्पाउस नहीं मिल रहा है. दैट इज कॉल्ड द वेटिंग फेज. किसी ने विल में आपका नाम लिखा, वो डेट नजदीक नहीं आ रही है. इसको क्या बोलते हैं? वेटिंग फेज. हाउ डू यू हैंडल योर सेल्फ और कंडक्ट योर सेल्फ इन दैट वेटिंग फेज? Another 10 seconds. See, I'm like practically trying to mobilize your inner thinking for going for the bigger one. The waiting phase, thinking and behavior. Just another 10 seconds. Don't start talking, just raise your hands.
Fight.
Just raise your hands. Just raise your hands. Yes, you?
20 years ago when I did my MBA, same thing had happened 20 years ago. I didn't have a job. The belief I will become big and the self-belief I'm on the right track.
normal B grade.
Fine, accept it. That is the waiting phase. I'm on the right track and one day I will achieve. That is the idea. Today you have achieved. Wherever you wanted to be, you achieved. But then this basic thinking, I am on the right track and I will achieve. With that consciousness and hope, a good word said, belief, is a good conduct in the waiting phase. Any other aspect or attitude?
Patience.
Impatient behavior is lesser human dignity, remaining patiently happy. And happily patient. अब ये दो वर्ड्स आप घर जाके शांति से सोचना। Patiently happy and happily patient. This is the right attitude in the waiting phase. We go for riches. We want riches in life. I'm talking materialistically. How many of you have a clear definition and a clear vision of difference between richness and wealthiness? Give me the difference between rich and wealthy. See, I'm giving you points to think big. Just think over it. Give me the difference in very clear words between being rich and being wealthy. Then this time something from you, because this is something near to your profession. Being rich and wealthy both.
Rich knows how to make money.
Yes, stand up at your place, gentlemen.
Rich knows how to make money. The wealthy knows how to manage money.
How to manage?
Money.
Okay. A primary difference. Thank you for that. Rich knows how to earn money or get money, and the wealthy knows how to maintain or spend, rather. Okay? A very primary one, but somewhere above that yourself.
Rich is the materialistic and wealth.
Knowledge is wisdom. A bit closer to quite big thinking.
Which is below that? Very sad.
Near to the best. Rich is materialistic and wealthy is all kinds of riches, not only just money, but relationships, your harmony with people around you. I just want one more thing added to it. Wealth includes character. Richness always doesn't include character. Wealthiness includes character. This is the difference between richness, that is rich and wealthy. Rich and wealthy. If somebody criticizes you and keeps on criticizing you for no reason, what will you think? Bolo. દરેકના જીવનમાં એક વ્યક્તિ તો એવી હશે કે તમને ગાળ દે 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 કરતી હશે, હા કે ના? અને સામે આપણે પણ કોકને કોકના માટે કોન્સ્ટન્ટલી એક નેગેટિવ ઓપિનિયન આપણા મનમાં હશે જ. What if somebody constantly criticizes you or have a bad mouthing for you 24/7, 365, 16? Now tell me, what would you think your attitude and aspects? I'll give you 10 seconds. Think over it. Think over it. Ashok, he is habituated. I'm not concerned. Whether he's habituated or not, are you concerned or not?
No.
That is important. You getting not concerned of it. Yes.
Something
give somebody
wrong.
Else a chance.
Something wrong in Becky.
Rakesh?
Huh?
Acha, okay. That's a very good big thinking. That two or three people in my life, he says, that is constantly they are criticizing me. Rakesh is a very good friend of mine, and he's on a transit, and so he has come to Mumbai from Surat today, and I welcomed him to our session today. And he's among the top three insurance people in the country. He's a very big real estate dealer in Surat. And he came up with a very fine point that practically in his life there are two or three people who are constantly abusing him. He said that. But I always prayed to God that in my life I want to see with my own eyes they coming up to the standards of human dignified living right in front of me. This is a very big thinking. And you are practically doing it. I think he deserves a big hand.
Something wrong with me. I do it both.
This is a very big thinking. Fine to say, difficult to practice, but then if you are practicing, definitely a big kudos to you as well, that something, if at all that is wrong, it's wrong with me. It's a very big thinking. At least once in some small relationships or something going haywire, if you give a small thought to yourself in this angle, it can be very, very helpful. You will immediately be opened to, the gates will open to your wrong side. The story. So that's a very big thinking, but then fine to hear from all of you. Nice to care and share for this kind of thinking. So thinking big is a basic human dignity, is a high human living, and it is a choice to be made, and it is an inherent character of human soul. We are all potentially capable of going for big thinking. Only thing, we have to break the barrier of animal instinct and rise to human dignified living. My all prayers for all of you. Thank you very much that you are all here today, and hope we meet again. Thank you very much.
Rakesh Bhai Patel, please.
Himanshu Bhai, vote of thanks kaise, pashi Devin Bhai bhi be akshar kaise.
Well, Swamiji ne bolya pashi apne imni vaato ne ek andar વિચારધારા માં રાખવાની અને એના પર આગળ વધારે તો મારાથી કંઈ બોલાય નહીં, પણ એક વાત જે મેં ક્યારેક સાંભળી હતી અને જે આજે સ્વામીજીએ પાછી કરી કે ભાઈ, અરે કદાચ મેં પહેલાં કહ્યું હતું પણ, કે વાઘને નથી કહેવું પડતું કે તું વાઘ થા. આજે આપણે છાપામાં જે મને કહ્યું કે ભાઈ 3 વર્ષની બાળકીને કે 4 વર્ષની બાળકીને, તો એમણે જે કીધું કૂતરો, કૂતરાને કેવું નથી પડતું કે કૂતરો થાય, એની આદત છે, એ જન્મથી જ કૂતરો છે. ગાયને કેવું નથી પડતું કે ગાય થાય, કારણ કે ગાય દૂધ આપે છે, પણ શા માટે માણસને જ કેવું પડે છે કે ભાઈ માણસ તો થાય, વાય. એટલે આપણે આ જ પ્રકૃતિમાં અત્યારના જે એમણે કહ્યું કે 21મી સદીમાં ગયા પણ નિમ્ન કક્ષાએ જીવી રહ્યા છે. એટલા માટે જ કે આજની તારીખમાં આપણને સ્વામીજી જેવાની વધારે જરૂરત છે. ચાર્ટર્ડ એકાઉન્ટન્ટ સાયન્ટિસ્ટ છે, જરૂરી છે, પણ જેટલો પ્રોગ્રેસ આપણે કરી રહ્યા છીએ તો એમાં આઈ વુડ વિશ અને મારી ભગવાનને પ્રાર્થના રહેશે કે આપણા સમાજમાં કે દુનિયામાં પણ સ્વામી ખરા અર્થમાં સ્વામી, ન કે રામ રહીમના અર્થમાં સ્વામી, પણ ખરા અર્થમાં સ્વામીજી આપણા વચ્ચે રહે. અને મારી ભગવાનને જ પ્રાર્થના છે. અને ઓન બિહાફ ઓફ ઓફિસ બેરર, મેનેજિંગ કમિટી મેમ્બર્સ, ટ્રસ્ટીઝ, આઈ થેન્ક ઓલ ઓફ યુ. અને આઈ થેન્ક શૈલેષભાઈ, ભલે અમારા જ છે, કે ઝૂ ક્લબમાં જે પણ આપણો માહોલ છે, હસી મજાક, સ્પોર્ટ્સ, કલ્ચર, એન્ટરટેનમેન્ટ, બાર, પણ ત્યાં આ જે આધ્યાત્મિક માહોલ આજે એમણે કરાવ્યો, આઈ થેન્ક શૈલેષભાઈ ઓલસો વેરી મચ. થેન્ક યુ વેરી મચ.
જય સ્વામી નારાયણ સ્વામી. પ્રણામ. વંદન ટુ ઓલ ઓફ યુ હિયર. વી હેવ હેડ અ મેસમેરાઇઝિંગ સેશન ધીસ મોર્નિંગ, આઈ મસ્ટ સે. એન્ડ ફોર લાસ્ટ ઓલમોસ્ટ વન એન્ડ હાફ અવર, ટુ આવર્સ સ્વામી યુ ડિડન્ટ રિયલાઇઝ 2 hours. Yes, absolutely. And what an energy you have, Swami. Yesterday, day before yesterday, you were in Nasik. Did the Shilanyas of the Nasik Mandir yesterday. Went to Jalna for talk. This morning took flight from Aurangabad. With us today, this morning. An afternoon. Just after this talk, you are leaving for Surat and going to address a large audience again in the evening at 6 o'clock. We are truly blessed, Swami. Thank you for this. Shailesh Bhai, I must thank you for giving me this opportunity to always say something about the talk that we have had today. In last 3 talks, Swami, in the club, in this year, you have touched upon some of the very fundamental aspects. In the first talk you talked about, and if I recall correctly, intellect quotients, emotional quotients and spiritual quotients. You showed us the way to go ahead in the life. In the second talk you told us about quantity fills, quality fulfills. And in that talk you showed us as to how to achieve something that you are aspiring. In today's talk, you have actually laid down the vision to achieve what we have thought about. And this is a powerful talk today, I must say. Thank you once again for this. As Himanshu Bhai said, and I truly acknowledge Shailesh Bhai, a wonderful job. You've been taking extraordinary efforts in bringing Swami to club and giving all of us this opportunity. Please continue to do so. Thank you all of you for this gathering once again. And we would like to meet Swami once again this year. Swami, normally in a year you have 12 months. Normally, I'm saying. You have only visited us 3 times in this year. This is unfair. So, the balance 4 months of this financial year, my request would be to at least make at least 2 visits in this particular 4 months. Thank you all very much.
Thank you, friends. Swamiji has promised me at least 4 sessions in a year. Next session, I will take the date sometime in the month of March. Thank you. Thank you very much for being at this. Thank you.